I miss you so much. I tried. I really did, but I can't. Just can't go on without you. I can't forgive myself for what I've done. I know this isn't what you would want. But I guess it doesn't matter anymore. You're not here. Are you?
Restless dreams, I see that town. Silent Hill. You promised you'd take me there again someday. But you never did. Well, I'm alone there now. In our special place. Waiting for you to come and see me. But you never do. So, I wait. Wrapped in my cocoon of pain and loneliness. I know. I've done a terrible thing to you. I wish I could change that, but I can't. I feel so pathetic and ugly laying here. Every day I stare up at the cracks in the ceiling, and all I can think about is how unfair it is. The doctor came today. Told me I could go home for a short stay. It's not that I'm getting better, it's just that this could be my last chance. Even so, I'm glad to be coming home. I missed you so much. But I'm afraid, James. I'm afraid you don't really want me to come home. Every time you come to see me, I can tell how hard it is on you. I don't know if you hate me or pity me. Maybe I just disgust you. I'm so sorry. When I first learned I was gonna die, I couldn't accept it. I was so angry. I struck out at everyone I loved. Especially you. And that's why I understand if you hate me. But I want you to know, I will always love you. Even though our life together had to end like this, I still wouldn't trade it for the world. Well, this letter has gone on too long. So, I'll say goodbye. I told the nurse to give this to you after I'm gone. Which means that, as you're reading this, I'm already dead. But that's okay. I'm not afraid of it anymore. I just hope the pain will end soon. So that you remember me for who I was. And not what the disease made me. I want you to go on. I want you to live. For yourself. And for others. Like you did for me. James. You made me happy.